Hey everyone, welcome to episode 12 of Sniper Elite 4 with Dave and Dylan.
Hi.
Dave.
Dave.
What? Do you need to drink more?
Yeah. I mean, I'm working on it.
Those guys are Mafia, right?
Yeah.
Just saying, everyone looks like the Mafia when they're in Italy. Why are they listening to a woman?
I don't know, because she's up there screaming death to fascists.
Soda. Do we say soda or pop here?
We say pop here, dog. You're the outlier.
I say soda.
Ah, beer.
It's funnier.
Soda is pretty funny.
Soda. So what have you done today?
We did some work this morning.
Yeah,
we did. This afternoon or a little bit.
I followed you around. Yeah. Hung out with my brother.
I wrote a closing statement for a trial.
This dude's like... He's trying to fuck with us, isn't he? If he fucks with us, I swear to God.
I probably would have already got pissed off and punched this guy in the face.
Yeah, that guy would have been shot in the liver.
Speaking of sniper guy, he reminds me I need to get a haircut.
Really?
Yeah.
Me too. That's the guy we just had the dossier on, right?
Yeah. Sounds like a good time.
Yeah. Does he know? Lieutenant. Are we actually a lieutenant?
Yeah.
No, I think we're still a sergeant.
No, we're a lieutenant.
No, not in...
Oh, yeah, no, our rank thing is like staff sergeant, but... Red Fox calling
Mother Hen. Red Fox extreme sergeant? Receiving you, Red Fox. Magazine and Coastal Facility unusually successful at sinking
Allied shipping. Neutralize naval guns and... Radar really, he has a cute voice.
She's gonna be ugly. Oh man, she's a computer.
No, it's some, I saw the voice credits for this game, and Radio Lady is actually fairly well known.
Is she?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, my favorite guy.
Fucking scary Mr. Rogers. Hotting up?
What the fuck? Like, why don't they just blow these places up? That'll probably be a side project. What do you think?
Yeah. All I know is that if this guy did all the shit that he did during the war, you got promoted fast in World War II because basically all the bad lieutenants died.
Yeah.
So then they needed company officers and, you know, all that kind of shit. So if this guy did all the shit that he really did, he would have been at least a lieutenant colonel by the end of the war.
Yeah, but he's not really a troop leader.
Doesn't matter, dude. Back then, you know, when you're in, you know, in charge of a commando squad or a commando, they'd promote you just for being a good commando.
So you get paid more?
Yeah, you get more prestige. And
okay, what are we doing here? You
need other people doing commando shit.
Okay, objectives. Find Kessler. Disable radar dish. Optional. Interpret, digest documents, or intercept, digest documents. Wreck the Codebreaker Center, and destroy German naval guns.
And assassinate the officer in charge.
Okay, let's do some aggressive stealth. Wow, that's a lot of dudes. That is a big gun. Plus two heavily armored vehicles.
Well, what kind of, how many silence rounds we got? This sounds like a good opportunity, sneaky beaky. Do at least have silence pistol bullets?
Eight,
okay, so swap over. Sneak up on that dude by the sandbags.
Right there?
Yep.
I can probably shoot him from here.
Well, just don't mess, we don't have a lot. Actually, first off, crouch right here and knock everyone, so we...
My dude's not going down. For some reason, he wouldn't fucking lay down. I was like, hitting C, and it's like, nah, I don't wanna. Kinda busy. What are you saying?
Binocular, everyone.
Oh, you want me to actually do that?
Yeah, you basically need to when you're gonna sneak.
Well, they all show up on the minimap.
Yeah, but they show up, like, they're easier to see with your eyes because they show up highlighted. Man, the window.
Oh. Potted plant.
Okay. So now we sneak.
I could probably cause a distraction by blowing that up.
Yeah, with the satchel charge?
No, with my gun. With my rifle.
Can you blow that up with your rifle?
Well, it's got a weak spot.
I think that just slows it down.
No, I think that's a fuel tank.
No, that's a muffler.
Is it? What about that?
You blow that up.
They still heard that. I actually didn't. The suppressed ammo was not as quiet as I thought it was.
I think they just saw him go down.
You think?
Yeah.
Hmm.
You probably sneak up on both those guys on the right and melee them.
Hold on. That guy's a spotter.
Oh. Probably be the best guy. One of the best guys to take out then.
Okay. There's lots of dudes over here now. Distraction. Am I stuck? Okay. Shit. I'll be fine. What are you doing on your phone over there?
No, I was trying to find the voice credits.
Ugh, man. Man, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Well, you saw me attempt to be stealthy, right?
I mean, yeah, like, it didn't go very great.
Now I gotta be aggressively stealthy.
You know, this game is apparently not getting, like, super great scores.
Why?
I don't know. It's just, it's getting sevens and eights.
Well, it's it's a pretty niche game, relatively, I mean.
Yeah, I suppose. I mean, I don't know. It seems like a solid 9 to me, but maybe it just speaks to me.
You gotta like sniper games before you give it that high of a score, though. You know?
I like to shoot stuff.
How's, have you seen the ratings for Honor?
No.
Austin was on Twitch earlier.
I believe they're very high, though.
Yeah, and they were just like shitload of them. Man. I have 4 ammo.
How did you do that?
How'd I do what?
Shoot 41 rounds.
Dude, I killed like 20 people.
Or, well, you don't start with a full load, do you?
Huh.
PC meta score is only 77.
That's not bad, actually.
6-6 user scores on
6-6 user scores?
Yeah, 6.6 on Metacritic.
Huh. Now that's... Huh.
I bet on Xbone it's way higher.
Shooters are more popular on Xbox?
It's not a shooter. Yeah, it's 82 on...
It's a shooter.
82 and 7. Well, it's not a shooter. It's a... It's a online...
Oh, are you talking about For Honor?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were talking about this.
No, yeah, an 81 on PS4. 6.9 user score. That kind of game's just more popular on console. Console scrubs didn't get their fill of Pirates Viking Knights back in the Half-Life 1 days.
Yeah, they didn't. They didn't play enough, obviously.
Underrated classic Half-Life 1 mod, by the way. There was a Half-Life 2 one that was pretty good, too.
Was there?
Yeah. I think it was just Pirates Viking Knights 2.
Yeah.
Or Source, one of the two.
Oh, man. Let me loot some dudes.
STG-44 seems to be panning out pretty good, though.
The one I'm using?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's pretty good. It's harder to use than the MP40.
It kicks more, so your shots are off more between shots.
But I'm getting there.
Those things are mechanically very interesting.
What are they? The gun I'm using?
Yeah. So they were at least arguably the first assault rifle, right?
Yeah.
There was a couple other things that kind of came before. I think the real first assault rifle was the Automat Fedorov.
What is that one?
That was a Russian... So Russia and Japan used to fight each other all the time.
Yeah.
Oh,
fucking all the time.
That was something they made during the Russo-Japanese War. It was made by Russia. And it was, like, shortly before World War One, like 1910 or 12 or something. And it shot... It was a select fire rifle.
Okay.
But the reason people don't want to call it an assault rifle, because it shot 6.5 Japanese, which is arguably a
That's how many people it could shoot?
Six and a half Japanese guys. 6.5 Japanese is arguably a full-powered rifle round, but really...
A little underpowered? Or?
Very underpowered for the day. It's about like, you know that AR I have in 6.5 Grendel?
Yep.
It's a little more powerful than that. It's not... It doesn't kick real hard. It's not real powerful.
Okay.
But the Japanese chambered bolt-action rifles in it, just because they like light recoiling rifles, and the ballistics on it are pretty good.
It makes sense. They're smaller frame people.
Yeah. And the ballistics on it are pretty good because it's a... The other thing about it is since it had a relatively low powder charge, with those big, long, full-length rifles they used to use, it had, like, no muzzle flash.
Yeah. Double down.
Nice. And, you know, that can be big when you're in a war because that's a big way people find who's shooting at them.
Right.
So...
Isn't that the benefit of, like, those subsonics and stuff?
No, those are quieter. Oh. So, when you use a silencer, you can silence the gun all you want, but if the ammunition is supersonic...
What does it matter?
It makes a sonic boom.
Yeah, I've seen that guy.
And it's still... Yeah, it's harder to locate the shooter, because the sonic boom's not directional like the gun report is.
Shit.
But,
No time to scratch my nose.
You know, if you're being truly stealthy instead of just trying to hide.
Panzer Faust. A whole lot. I don't know where, though.
Right.
Yeah, look at the indicators. I know there's dudes to the right.
Yeah, I thought one of those was the Panzer Faust guy. That seemed to be where it was coming from.
He had a rifle. Or a assault rifle.
Yeah, machine gun. The butt of what he had looked like either an MG-34 or 42.
Man, this is, we're getting a lot of our killing out early.
Yeah.
I believe there was a quote you wanted to make.
Oh boy, here I go killing again. I told Scooter that before we went deer hunting, and he looked at me like I was a maniac.
You are.
Well, fair enough.
Look at all those dudes over there.
Yeah. Yeah, they keep coming.
It'll be like just every other map. I mean, there,
might
there
be that guy. Yeah, let's just say
he's the dude with the tube on his back.
Yeah, yeah. The back tube's a pretty big giveaway.
DOS back tube. Okay, I gotta move fast. I got ammo. SMG ammo. Officer, another. We've already got three of the four duty rosters.
Does the Sturmgewehr use the same generic SMG ammo as everything else?
Yeah, everything's one of three categories. I'm going to use...
Shoot it? Okay, yeah, that'll probably work. They'll probably detonate each other.
Yeah, I didn't want to risk it. Free XP, I mean... Oh!
Double kill.
I did not expect that. Must have been the Spanish Inquisition.
I do hear nobody ever expects those guys.
Well, no ammo. Better start sniping with my assault rifle, right?
Yeah. Have you seen Fury with Brad Pitt?
Yeah.
It's a good movie.
Of course I've seen that. I'm your friend.
I couldn't remember if I made you watch that one day or not.
I assume you invested in that movie the way you watch it.
No, I don't think I bought it, actually.
No, I mean, I should. I meant like.
Oh yeah, no, I was an investor in the production company. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I actually own 5% of the.
Of the gross.
Of the rights, yeah.
Serious smoke over here. Huh, I figured there would be ammo in here.
Well, it might be down on the ground floor.
I'll use the door.
That's one of the, that's one of those Hollywood tricks, by the way. You always, if you're ever doing something...
Always use the door?
You always want part of the gross, not part of the profits. Because what they do is they start a separate LLC for every movie.
Right, you told me that.
They have to pay tribute and stuff to the production company. And most movies never make a profit. That's one of the reasons that George Lucas and David Proust, the guy that played Darth Vader, fucking hate each other. Is Proust got fucked on Empire. And,
right.
Maybe Jedi, too. They're like, oh, Richard, we...
can't pay you. Didn't make any
money. We can't pay you a lot up front, but how about 3% of the profits or a percent or something? And he's like, oh yeah, that's great. No, the first one did great. We'll make lots of Star Wars money. That's fine. Oh man, sorry, Richard.
Light machine gun ammo.
Yeah, dude, the FG-42. Take that.
What'll it replace?
I thought that might have been what he had. It'll probably replace your
my submachine gun. That's a different ball game, isn't it?
Yep. So that's the. Fallschirmjäger Gewehr 42. It is a light machine gun made specially for paratroopers. They shot regular 8mm Mauser.
Uh-huh.
20 round. It's basically a German BAR.
Okay.
Only instead of
it's me Bren gun.
Only it's really light.
Okay.
They all had telescopic sights, which was, basically unheard of back then.
Hmm.
And they were real nice rifles. They had this, how some guns shoot from an open bolt, some guns shoot from a closed bolt?
Yeah.
And machine guns usually shoot from an open bolt because it cools better and all that stuff. So it had a neat thing. It was select fire. You could use it as a rifle or as a light machine gun.
Okay.
When you had the selector in semi-automatic... it would shoot from closed bolt for better accuracy. But then when you flipped it to automatic, it'd start keeping the bolt back and shoot from open bolt.
That's a pretty intricate design.
It is, but they worked really well. They were one of the best guns of the war. The M60 is largely a direct copy of the FG-42 with a belt feed system added.
Huh. How many rounds can you put through a machine gun like that without having to wait for it to cool down?
You don't. You change the barrel.
Hmm.
And
unless you have a water jacketed one?
Yeah. And the answer is it depends entirely on how fast you shoot them.
Interesting.
If you're really ripping them off, it's only a couple hundred. If you're taking your time, you never need to change the barrel.
Only have to do one?
Yeah. Dude, like I said, those things were like 15 pounds of C4.
It's going to cause an explosion, isn't it?
Probably.
That thing's fucking huge.
Yeah.
I'm going to put a mine here. I doubt there's anyone left.
Sight in on that.
Sight in on what?
The FG-42. Let's see if it was any of your scope.
No, but it's got a really small reticle.
Yeah.
Which is great, because that's the main problem I have with the other one.
Yeah, right. I kind of figured it would be like that. That was part of the reason why I told you to take it. We don't have a lot of bullets for it, though, do we?
A 22. I assume we'll find more if we found this one, so.
Yeah, well, and hopefully when we hit a red crate or something, it'll fill us up.
Yeah. Well, I've been looking for one of those.
Let's go ahead and take the silencer off our pistol so it's ready when we inevitably need it.
Really, there's no ammo in here? fucking med kits.
There's something on the other desk.
Yeah, fucking pistol.
Oh, yeah. Hey, do you want to trade our 45 for a 32 ACP?
No. Not at all. What am I supposed to be finding in here?
Maybe a 380, I don't know. I don't know, I think this was probably just an alternate way to get up there.
Oh, wreck the code-breaking center. That's what I'm doing now.
Okay, so we just, like, run in there and shoot all those things, or? Presumably there's some place to put a bomb, because that's what this game does when it wants us to wreck things.
I believe these things. Nope. Just kick it.
That's a decryption machine, so yeah, I guess.
Oh, Luger?
Yeah, I mean, Luger's fine.
That was dangerous as fuck.
Oh, you mean you shouldn't body slam the thing that kind of explodes when you break it?
Jesus. Might as well do that while we're over here since we've pretty much killed all those dudes already.
More than likely. Can we jump over there?
Let me scope it out real quick.
Fair enough.
Nice. Oh, fuck that guy.
That was the officer in charge guy we were supposed to kill.
Wait, what?
That was an objective. That was the officer in charge we were supposed to shoot.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Am I the coolest?
You are the coolest.
I am the greatest.
Yeah, that was the... you know how one of our objectives was kill the officer in charge of the shore defense battery?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was that guy.
Huh. Well, the thing's not open, is it?
No, it wasn't red.
No, those two things right there.
Yeah, they weren't red, though.
No, they gotta be open, man.
Oh.
Whoops. Fucking ghetto tank.
Where's that dead Panzerfaust?
It's fucking all the way over there or something.
Okay. I was going to say, if we were by him, we could probably, I
wonder if you can shoot these off. Is he turning around? He sure is. Oh, this is going to be close, Dave.
It's open now.
Boom. Boom. Big leak. Boom. Pretty sure they only did like the one animation.
So there should be four guys in that tank.
I wish there was a way to snipe out the gunner, but there really wouldn't be, would there?
Well.
I think I can blow it up with that.
I don't know. I mean, it's not going to hurt to try.
I've only got 8 ammo.
Let's not try.
That was effective. Cool. I want to run down to the bottom of this building and see if there's a crate.
Yeah. No, we need one of those. That's reasonable. Something out there.
Ah, yeah, ammo. Ah, shotgun ammo, the thing I needed, Dave. I'm glad these people know me so well. Shitload of light machine gun ammo.
That's good. We needed that.
Should probably use that in here, shouldn't I?
Probably.
I'm not seeing anything. This place is, big. Tin ammo? That's yep. Not bad.
Yeah, hand grenade.
Yeah, I mean, I got several things from that. Back upstairs. Can't believe that I already shot that one dude.
That was pretty good. Yeah, extra hand grenade is always good.
Okay. So we gotta locate some dudes and destroy some more guns. All clear, Dave. No one's hurting anyone over here.
Everything's fine. There's not a world war going on or anything.
We've had a weapons malfunction. Everything's fine down here, though.
Send someone in to check it out. No, there's a pretty big leak in the reactor.
Okay, so you, how much time we got, Dave?
We're right at 30.
Are you shitting me? You actually no. been...
Yeah, I moved it.
Damn.
See? The red dot's where it starts, and we're over there.
Let me blow up this tank, and then we'll start over.
All right.
Is that the tank spying me?
I think so, yeah. Oh.
My cover's blown, Dave.
You should get the fuck out of here.
I got the fuck out.
I feel like there's another parked tank over there.
There might... it's a wrecked tank.
Okay.
Okay, so that's a good place to stop.
Yep, and we'll be back.
We'll be back for 13.
With episode 13, yeah.
Yep.